Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for this opportunity that Mfundi Sumlotwa anyipayona, and always enjoy to be with him as my friend, as the pastor together, and appreciate the time we have. And thank you yesterday. I saw most of you that was nice and great. At the end, someone said, "Namiyafunu kshata," and said, that's good. But Uprada Jeff, no Uprada Ray, have a fool, have a bone. My God, have a peg, Uprada Jeff, no Ray, a zang batone. And then in this year, I got a color of CC, but I couldn't see none. She's a Kuruman, she's a Tandaz, and something goes is over Vuda. Amen. And thank you for Mom Fundi. She did a very good job yesterday. That was awesome for me. And Mom Fundi, that was awesome. And thank you for the support and support. And I'm Fundi, I'm fasting down with our Fundi school. So go back to school. Yes, I'm being up in a president. I left my, where's my airport? Where's my this? Being a Sawi in the Shumayda Lanam Clan. And going to be on Pet and Shumayda Wanda, they did none. Being Shiama notices of my pretty paper this season. But because of negative Englishman, they didn't even get a Zangan for Mr. Jed as I'm born again. But before we go to the word of God, let's pray then and we pray. Our Father, thank you for your grace in this morning, and that you are God and you will rise up in our heart and to cause our mind and our heart to burn with zeal as it required, so that we can be a great testimony into the community and to the people near us that these are the children of God. And we thank you for saving us. We thank you for Jesus Christ. We thank you for giving us something that we have never thought that we need. You have given your only Son so that we can come to you and become yours. Father, work in us, work in our heart, work in our life, continue to be God. And we know we need you more than you need us. And there's nothing that you can get from us, only our sin, because we are continuously sinners in our behavior, in our thoughts, in our action, in our fallen mind, everything of us. But when you are present in us, we know that, Lord, you will change us, you will humble us, you will cause us to tremble before you, you will cause us to see your grace and your great mercy towards us, the love that you bestow and share, even in our shameful situation. When you are there, we become so comfortable and rest in your sovereign grace that the Lord is with us and there's nothing too hard for him who cannot do anything for us. We ask you and we pray, give us the ears of hearing and the understanding of your word as we pray. In Christ we thank you. Amen. Take our Bible to the book of Acts, chapter 3 and 4. We are in the book of Acts, where we are in the church. And today we're supposed to preach there from verse 13, and which I'll give here. But because I didn't preach with chapter 3, we'll combine chapter 3 and 4 together. We'll pick up some verse from chapter 3. And 4. But let's read one verse from chapter 4, and then that will be from verse 13 to verse 22. But let's speak with this one verse, and then take one also in chapter 3. Ngizo ifunda ngesiZulu ngale Bible engiliphethe. Base bebabiza babayala ngokuthi bangakhulumi ngabafundi bangafundisi nakanye ngegama likaJesu. Let me repeat that, verse 18. Base bebabiza bebayala ukuthi bangakhulumi bangafundisi nakanye ngegama likaJesu. Ake siye ku chapter 3. verse 6. Kodwa uPetro wathi, isiliva negolide anginalo, kepha lokhu enginako ngikupha kona, egameni likaJesu waseNazaretha, hamba. Verse 6, chapter 3. Kodwa uPetro wathi, isiliva negolide anginalo, kepha enginako ngikupha kona, egameni likaJesu Kristu waseNazaretha, hamba. Yes, we will read in English.
But Peter said, I have no silver and gold, but what I do have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk.
Chapter 4, verse 18.
Chapter 4, verse 18. So they called them and charged them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus.
Amen. We live in a world of names. Names are associated with a lot of things. There are some names that are historical names. Names like Hitler, that people, they know them from past events. And they, behind that name of Hitler, there are certain things that people can remember. There are great names of people that we can also, when we hear them, we think that that name was not great. That person in that name, he was not a good one. And we have some names that we can mention that are good names. When a lot of people love those names. When you speak of Nelson Mandela, a lot of people love him for the freedom they gave and all that. And God gave names. He even called Adam to give names to animals. We have names that we can mention and we associate certain things around that name. When you speak of Musipe, we know his financial is rich. When you speak for those who are poor, there are names that are being called by them so that we can identify them and know them. When people call you Lazarus, you know that you're poor. Yeah. Whenever they don't want to say you're poor directly to you, like, Lazarus. And even if you have your own name, then you know that you are Luto. And all those names are important because they give certain identity. But also for us to be saved, God has never given us anything. He has given us his son. Amen. And under that son, he just gave us a name. That name will be Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And in that name, there's a lot of things that are in the name of Jesus Christ. And with that name is the name where we stand, where we speak, where we preach, where we do anything, and nothing else that we do. And this is the only name that God has given me and you and everyone in this world so that we can come back to him and reconcile with him. And that name is the name that we see in the book of Acts, that it is the name that caused havoc in a lot of situations where the apostles are going. As I've heard now, when your pastor said we need to go, and also Brother Imran, that we need to go outside to the community. We need to go and preach the gospel and do all these things. And what is it that we are going with? What is it that we're going, that we have, and we're going to give to the people? There's nothing that we can give them and change their life. If Jesus Christ is not the center, if we are not carrying the name of Jesus and the work of Jesus Christ to the community, whatever we carry, it won't last for them. It won't help them. It won't do anything for them. The name of Jesus is a name that eliminates everything. It eliminates other persons, and also it eliminates any other name. There is no other name that is given to men. As Peter said in chapter 3, verse 12, that man may be saved, the name of Jesus. You don't need Muti. You don't need anything. You need the name of Jesus. And what is it that is in the name of Jesus? What is it that is in the name of Jesus? Why this name? And the Bible has given all this definition with it, this name. We know Jesus in his finished work, he has done a lot of things. And this morning, without wasting a lot of time concerning this chapter 3 and 4 that I will expound to you just now, we will look at four important works of the name of Jesus that is found in this book of Acts, in these two texts. The important four things that is found in the work of this name Jesus that is found in this. Where we are in chapter 3 and 4 is after chapter 2, where the apostle receive the Holy Spirit. And after receiving the Holy Spirit, even before they receive it, in chapter 1, before Jesus ascend, he said they must wait in Jerusalem until the coming of the Holy Spirit come to them. And when it comes, now all people visibly saw that. And there were a lot of things that were happening that have never happened in the day of Pentecost. Look at this. When Jesus rose from the dead, he spent 40 days with some of his apostles and other people who testified that he rose from the dead. And after 40 days, he went up and ascended to heaven. And then after 10 days, there was Pentecost, which made 50. And in the Pentecost, every Jew and every foreign or proselyte or anyone, they come, there's a good conference at Jerusalem. And it occupied a lot of people. Jews from all over the world, they come there and gather. And in that moment, God was at work. And how God worked was to testify about Jesus in that conference. Even if that conference was made, was a religious conference hosted by the priest and everyone. And everyone who's a Jew, they know that they need to go there. It was something that has become a tradition to do, and they go there. But on that Pentecost of that day, there was a lot of changes that happened. The descending, the coming down of the Holy Spirit, not to everyone, but to those who are with Jesus Christ. And one of the things that the Holy Spirit does when he comes in chapter 2, he gives all those who are with Jesus, he gives them power, he gives them languages to speak without going to school. And they were speaking not that they were eloquent, but they speak that people could hear them, and not hearing them, but hearing them speaking good works of God. Amen. And it caused people to be amazed. And in that chapter 2, we see Peter standing up and start preaching. Because in their amazement, they thought that these people were drunk. And some say, what is it that is happening? Because that was a different Pentecost than Aaron. Because the presence and the coming of the Holy Spirit. And also, the disciples of Jesus were there. And with boldness now, Peter started to stand. Because they said they were drunk. And this is normal. We know now, Tanish. Only few who drink. We know that. And we okay, no, but even no mundo tuli, then no tuli. Once what are so gotta behave different. By my driver, by my kana, by my kulmakakulu, Yamunaminamzala, Yamunaminamanum, Ubakuma, Nendoma is, but if no kuluma just get this eating. And people associated them with that, oh, I love what I give, must have a color. If the power that was within them now caused them to speak the work of God. And not only because they know those people that were Jews, they only know, like, this is Judah Pen. It's like if you know certain people who come from Venda, this one they know Venda only, they speak Venda language. Or this one, a Zulu who are stubborn, they don't know any other language, they can speak Zulu, whatever, wherever they are. They are fundama foot, abawaza my language. But suddenly, at the moment, now bafana saka khuluma isiVenda, ndadi masheroni ni angasifunda. What's going on, man? And yile nenze enjalo practical. And that change was noticeable. Everyone was aware with that. Those who were there, they noticed that. It's the same thing when a person is drunk, we can notice. When he start to walk, we can see. When he start to speak, we can say that something is not right. But because we have an understanding of certain circumstances, said this is drunk. But that understanding that day in the Pentecost was so confusing. But to threaten the confusion, Peter stood up and preach his first sermon without any fear. The same Peter, if we go back 30-something days, who denied Jesus, now he stand and preach and point to them. And we see John 16 in place there, where Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit came, he will convict of sin, of judgment, and also of righteousness. And some were convicted and said, what should you do? And he said, repent, repent. Then in chapter 3 now, we see the disciples also going to do something that is obvious for everyone who's saved. Once you are saved by God in Jesus Christ and you are being controlled, you have been given the Holy Spirit and is giving you, there's one thing that you will always think of. Prayer will become a priority. It will always come to you that I need to pray. Whenever circumstances come, your only solution is just to pray. Yeah. Even if you don't have anything. Sometimes I say, even if they can take everything from you, in your hands and everywhere, there's something that we are left with if you are a believer. If you are a child of God, there's something that no one can take it. Prayer is always available to you. You are always given an opportunity and a time to go to God, to pray to God, in the car, in the taxi, everywhere. You can always have that. A true believer won't be disassociated with prayer. He will always love prayer. In his dreams, in his thoughts, in everywhere. Prayer is a communication to God. Prayer wants to listen to God. Prayer want to talk, you want to talk to God because you are giving those two opportunities. Like, now pray, let God hear your prayers and God enjoy you when you pray and God is willing to listen to your prayer. Prayers are given to the saints. Saints are supposed not to complain too much, but are supposed to be prayerful people. They're supposed to live the life of prayer. You remember back in the gospel, when the disciples saw Jesus as an example, he was doing that practically before them. He always prayed. And they come to the thought, the way Jesus was praying, it reached their mind and their heart and said, no, Lord, do what?
Teach us
to pray. And that was his ministry. As they went to the ministry of prayer in chapter 3, they find a man who was there. And in chapter 4, we're giving you that man was 40 years old. He was always in that temple. It means as this, he was 40 years old, and Jesus died at 33 years old. That man was 7 years older than Jesus. Jesus did went to Jerusalem. Maybe he saw that man, but he didn't want to interfere. God knows everything. That maybe he was reserved for this, so that the gospel will go out through that man. And Peter and John went to the time of prayer in the temple. The man was there, and he looked at them. And as he looked at them, and they called him, stood up, with the hope that he's going to give. And one thing that we should look here, and this situation we always have, Anish. Kunabantu abahlale bacela, Anish. Noma ngaqala i-100 rand umnike namhlanje, kusasa ukhona ekhona nokuphi. But in this instance, lo muntu ikhono lakhe bekusendaweni la abantu baye esontweni, because mawungena esontweni uyathasheka every time ngomuntu ombona anjani anjani, and the only help that the muntu babamnika ngayo bamkolekele njalo. That's why even nala emamlori emakhoneni ema-bus stop everywhere you see abantu abanye, ukuze benze ukuthi i-conscious yethu icabange kangcono ukuthi kumele sinikele, beze nabantwana abancane bahlale laphaya estradini. Ukuze balo abanye akusuke ukuthi ba-cripple banjani, but lo beka-cripple, abanye bakhona ba-cripple, ama-disabled, abanye amehla abo banjani. Ngizama ukuletha into a context right yalabantu abanjani. And always what we do, we give the money because we thought that is the only thing that we can do. Anish was alone. 20 rand now, just ngoba vele balapha for imali. It's the same thing with this man. At the beautiful gate, he was there. But this time, it was different.
Yes.
Because there were people who were led by the Spirit of God.
Mm.
And God in his sovereignty drove them. And when they see that man, Peter with bold said, look at us. Silver and gold we don't have.
Yes.
Because that's what always people give for that people in that need. And they say, in the name of Jesus, rise up. The miracle happened. And everyone was shouting. And in chapter 3, Peter started to preach. He said, no, 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 wait, men of Jerusalem. Don't think that this was done by our own power. Now we preach Jesus Christ. Chapter 4, it's the same thing. It's a continuation of this. The corner at Jerusalem and the whole crowd. And abantu bakholwa that day. They believe more than people. And mabakholwa abantu babo ukuthi then they appeal their servants. Angikhulume nani manje. Monga kulithatha serious ivangeli. Ukuze abantu abangaliboni balibone kuwe ulenze practical bal observe. Abantu ngeke balibelieve. Sometimes we now, we are not in the business of talking. We are in the business of displaying the truth. Let people see the light of the truth. Let people see the truth of the gospel practiced by us publicly and openly. Let people see you different than any other person. Because most of people ababelieve ngokuzwa, abanye bafuna ukubona kuqala. Abanye bafuna ukuzwa nokubona kodwa still bangabelieve. Kodwa your light that shine, let it shine. For example, we have opportunities, all of us, to make that shine. There is a need of people to see that maralabo, maralo, maralo putilo sisi lomntwana. No, kuna something I. Even if they don't know. Why? There is commonality of sin around our community. Sin is common around our community. Abantwana abancane abana 13, 14 But when you distance yourself from these things and you don't do those things, they begin to question your action. And that is an opportunity now to present to them the gospel. It draws attention when your friends are commonly doing the same thing and you go with them, because the Lord is not sending us to anyone. The Lord is sending us to people. The Lord does not call us to come out of people. He says we are in the people and we are in this world, but we are not like the world. We don't behave, we don't act like the world. When we come, there must be some different, because we have been born again and we have been given a name that is above every name. And that is the situation we face. What is it that we face in our community? We face people with nyawupe. We face people hope, and we are around them. We don't even give certain things, certain hope that comes from the scripture. We don't give prayers that come from the scripture. We don't want to live around them so that they come to us even if we don't see them and say, yes, I'm struggling, but I see you always like this. What is it that you are doing? The gospel in you that is being lived alive should attract certain things to you. It must be a magnet that attracts. Even when you go, it shall do that. Yeah. And Peter did that and they preached. And what they do, it attracted the Pharisees and all them. They were present. And they put them in this. And then if you speak in this, just link this in these two chapters. Chapter 4. And bafundisa uJesu abantu abaningi babezwa basindiswa. And those who were in trouble, the Pharisees. Look at verse 5, chapter 4. Step to verse 4. Bafunda ngesiZulu bafunda ngesiLungu. Ngepha abaningi kabezwanga izwi. Abaningi kwabezwayo izwi bakholwa. Umumo wamadoda waba ngathi izinkulungwane ezihlamba. Those who believed were more than 5,000. Kwathi ngamamuso, the next day, wabuthana eJerusalem ababusi, amalunga nababhali, nabapriesti. Verse 6, those are in authority. Those are government. Those are people of Jerusalem who rule. Verse 6, the Anas umpriest omkhulu, no Kephas, not Johann, No Alexander, nabo bonke abendlu yobupriest obukhulu. That was the highest office by that day. Baba Misa phakathi kwabo bababuza bathi lokho nikwenze ngaliphi ngamandla ngamapi amandla nangaliphi igama nami. Khona Petre gcwele umoya ongcwele wathi kubo nina babusi bezizwe namalunga. Nxa nisibuza namuhla ngomsebenzi omuhle kumuntu ogulayo ukuthi yena usindiswe ngani, makwazeke kini nonke nasezizweni zonke nasesizweni sonke sakwa-Israyeli ukuthi ngegama likaJesu Kristu waseNazaretha enambethele esiphambanweni amvusayo uNkulunkulu kwabafileyo ngayo umi lo muntu phambi kwenu. Yena uyitshe eladelwa yinina bakhi elasaba elaba yinhloko yegumbi. Ayikho insindiso ngomunye, ngokuba alikho futhi elinye igama phansi kwezulu elinikwe ebantwini esimele kusindiswa ngalo. Kwathi bebona isibindi sikaPetro noJohane beqonda ukuthi bangabantu abangafundile bayimifundaze nje, bamangala bababuza ukuthi babona babazi ukuthi kade benoJesu. Kepha bebona umuntu ophilisiwe emi nabo babengena kuphika lutho, kodwa sebayalile ukuba baphume emphakathini babaluleka bodwa bathi siyakubenzani labantu na, ngokuba kusobala kubo bonke abakhile eJerusalema ukuthi izibonakaliso ezigqamileyo zenziwe yibo, asinakuphika. Kodwa ukuze kungabi kusanda phakathi kwabo, asibayale bangabe besakhuluma kumuntu namunye ngaleli gama. Verse 18 losokhulumela ngayo. Base bebabiza babayala ngokuthi bangakhulumi bangafundisi nakanye ngegama likaJesu. Kepha oPetro noJohana baphendula bathi kubo, nqumani namhla nina ukuba kulungile yini emehlweni kaNkulunkulu ukulalela nina kunoNkulunkulu, ngokuba thina asinakuyeka ukukhuluma ngalokho esikubonileyo nesikuzwileyo. Khona sebebabayalile futhi babayeka bengafumananga ukuthi bangabajezisa kanjani ngenxa yabantu, ngokuba bonke bedumisa uNkulunkulu ngalokho okwenzileyo, ngokuba umuntu esenziwe kuye lesi sibonakaliso sokuphulukiswa wayeneminyaka eve emashumini amane. I want us to speak about the name of Jesus. We know this, the church started to be persecuted indirectly and patiently, say, ningasakhulumi ngaleli gama. And you'll notice two things as khona la. The whole priesthood eyabula uJesu khona. Nabantu abakade bathi crucify him bakhona. Now, the word of God is coming alive. The word that says signs and wonders will follow them that believe. And the Jews required a sign in 1 Corinthians is the same example. In order to see that Jesus was the Messiah, this was done in Jerusalem. This was done in the context of Hebrew people. This was done where Jesus was walking. This was done to the people who said on the cross, crucify him, crucify him. This was done by the same priest and the Pharisees and Sadducees, who organized Pilate, who organized Caiaphas and all that. They were all together as one. But after the resurrection of Jesus and all that, when the apostles start now to go and spread, there was a division now. Those who were in the high office were still saying the same thing. We don't want to hear anything. And the people now are becoming saved. The same people say crucify them, they are becoming saved. And the great worry now come to the Pharisees and the priests and the Sadducees, those who are leaders. What should we do with these people? And the instruction that was concluded in that meeting was this. They fear the people. Say, if we do something, because the people now are against us, are not with us like before at the cross. Because in the cross, it was God's provision so that men would receive salvation. But now, people are not with us. But there's only one thing that will help. Let them stop to speak about that name. Let them shut up to speak about that name. And the reason being that the Sadducees does not believe in resurrection. The high priest, okay, first and all that, they say, they send the lies, they spread, that they send people and say, Jesus akavukanga. And people should believe it akavukanga. And the message that Paul and John is what Jesus was raised from the dead. And they witnessed him. They saw him. Peter was fearful. Now at Pentecost and also after Pentecost when they moved to Jerusalem, he was not fearful. Peter had good intention before the cross that I will die with Jesus. And when he was supposed to face the reality, he feared. But now Peter, who's full and controlled by the Holy Spirit, is no longer fearful, is bold. And all the threat that they are throwing at him, he's standing there and he's speaking publicly without any fear. And the question is, I think Bruce, uzomenza umuntu obona umuntu ofile wavuka wambona nyukela yaphezulu uzomthusa ngani ngoba manje sekusuke uvalo lokusaba ukufa. The only thing they want abasithusa ngayo ukufa ngisho mawungenzi certain things uzofa ngisho. And Christians should be bold about that. We should be prepared to die. And the only persecution is to close our mouth and kill us and disappear as if there is nothing. That's why they told them that we only allow you to speak anything, but don't speak about the name of Jesus. Because it gives them trouble and all that. That's why this name is so powerful. There is something in the name of Jesus. And I want to present to you these four reasons why the name of Jesus. Even if the church is under persecution here, there is peace in the name of Jesus. If you want peace, in the name of Jesus, there is peace. Because in Isaiah chapter 9, that this is the Prince of Peace. God will give us a son, and he is the Prince of Peace. There is no peace in the world. There is no peace in the heart of man. There is no peace in the head of man. Men are troubled to and fro, but there is peace in the name of Jesus. And how does that peace come? Firstly, you need to believe that Jesus is Lord. You need to believe that. You need to believe that Jesus was sent by God. You need to believe that God has given us his son and he has named him Jesus. When the angels speak to Maria that Jesus, he will be the savior. He is the savior. When we sing this Christmas song, joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth rejoice because the savior has come. You need to believe that. You need to trust that. Is that thing too hard? Is that thing too difficult? That peace comes from believing Jesus. That peace comes from confessing that I am a sinner. I need a savior. He is the savior of my soul. That peace comes by true repentance, not resisting repentance, but repenting from your sin, knowing that you are a sinner. I have sinned against God. There's nothing good on my side. And that peace comes from wrestling with yourself, trying to make some means so that you can survive. Then Jesus' name, in that name, there is peace in that name. And it is peace that goes to our culture. It is peace that goes to our family. It is peace that goes to our heart. We become at rest. That's why Jesus will always say, come unto me, all those who labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Yeah. There is peace in that name. Give me some a believer who's controlled by the Holy Spirit. I will see peace, someone who is so peaceful, who's never be threatened or be troubled by any situation. There is always peace, like the peace that Jesus that said to the storm and the wind, peace be still to you, and it died and dried. It is hard today that you find believers abanomsindo, abanayo abalwayo, abanama confusion every day. People who see trouble and problem, who don't have peace, anything in none they ever move. Anything in none, even as in this thing I was born. Nothing. Let me tell you, the Pharisees and the priests didn't have peace because they resisted the peace. They resisted Jesus Christ. Anything done in the name of Jesus was troubling them every time. That's why they have to make a lot of plans. You know what you have to listen to? Abatagata bana kutula. Because they are the enemies of good things. Let's put it into context. What do you expect, what do you think that we, the committee is supposed to do with the leaders? A man being crippled, who is 40 years, maybe from birth, who was struggling at the gate, he received grace. What do you think running a connection in your mind love a person? He was not needing that money. Sometimes we need money to buy things, but it's not a solution for our life. It's not a solution for everything that troubles us. It's not something that will take our worries away and all that. There are a lot of people who have money who are corrupt, who are useless, who are evil to the core, who use money to advance their wrongdoing, like the Pharisees, like the priest in Jerusalem, who always take money as something to do evil and have power over all those who are poor and have power to those who are not having same equal position to them. There are people who think power and position is the way to control and to do more harm and more evil. And let me tell you this thing. Don't fear those people. They don't have peace. They always like to hide, to close everything that they're doing, not one see. What do you think the priest, the high priest, why they're troubled by this name? Because when this name gives you peace, it gives you light of understanding of situation, it makes them clear. It gives you knowledge and wisdom. It gives you strength and everything. There is peace in the name of Jesus, and that peace is found through salvation. That's why Peter said there is no other name given to man. Whether you are black, whether you are white, whether you are blue, whether you are Zulu, whether you are Pedro, Shangan, there's one commonality. There's one name that eliminates every name, the name of Jesus. If you are here this morning, you want peace, and you are struggling with sin, and you are struggling with a lot of things, there is a name that can take you out. If you are here this morning, you are struggling, you have sleepless night because of things that you cannot do, of things that are in your shoulder. You are carrying a burden of things that you don't know what to do, and you have tried everything. You have gone from far, from north to east, to try to find solution so that ube nokuthula, man, ube nokuthula under all situation. Ungabi nomona, ungabi nomhopho, ungabi nenhliziyo embi, ube right, ube satisfying anything. There is a name, the name of Jesus. That is why we should not stop to tell people that there is a name that is above every name, the name of Jesus. It is the name that will give you peace. Amen. And let me tell you, the highest form of that peace, you'll have peace with God. Amen. You'll pass from judgment. You will be given the forgiveness of sin. That gives me ultimate peace. You will have forgiveness of sin. Uhambe mami Lord. Uhambe mahube. Uhambe mol. Uhambe namali. Nomune mal. Uhambe mkukwini. Nomune nginengul. When you have Jesus and get that peace of Jesus, his salvation and everything, you know for sure there is one thing. I have been forgiven with God. Death should not be your trap. You must be willing to die, because you have already died from your sin, and someone has died to pay the cost of your sin, and his name is Jesus. He said, come unto me. Come unto me. I will give you rest. Abantu bakumele bafe inkinga enkulu ngoba neyinkinga bazishiyile emhlabeni, abazi kuzokwenzakalani kanjani. Abantu bayasaba ukufa ngoba bayazi ukuthi abazi bewuphikana bayothini kuNkulunkulu. Yes, God loves you, but God loves in Jesus Christ. Apart from that other name of Jesus, there is no salvation. My name cannot save you. The name of your church in the local church cannot save you. The name of Mangonde, the name of Mdise, the name of Zoresta, the name of Shagazulu, any name will never save your soul. The name of the people you idolize will never save you, but only the name of Jesus. That is why we as a church, we should keep preaching Jesus, until people get irritated. We have no message, but one message, that there is a Savior, and that Savior is other than anyone, but his name is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that's where we find peace.
Amen.
You'll never rest until you rest in the love of Jesus Christ. God loved you and he gave you something. He gave you Jesus to save your soul. In the name of Jesus, there is peace. Do you have peace this morning? What is it that troubles you? What is it that keeps you making sleepless night? Let me tell you, even if you have debts, they have nothing when you come to the name of Jesus. Even you are not employed. The great Christians are not employed. They are trying and all that. But God is meeting their need in different ways. Do you have peace?
Sure.
Let me ask you, man, I believe. Has the name of Jesus worked for you? Has that name of Jesus worked in your soul? That I'm free. That I say, it is well with my soul. It is well. What peace like a river attended my ways. Whatever my Lord God has taught me to say, it is well, because no one can sing that song unless he has met the person of Jesus Christ and is real in his soul. This is not about everyone, but it's about those who believe. Do you believe? If you don't believe, you won't have peace. Don't play church, but be really. Don't be saying, I saw to him saying, yes, must pull a ganje, samba ganje, makwenzi wanje ganje. Don't know the system of the church. You need to know the person of Jesus. He must be real. He must be real in you. And everyone will see. And you will be a magnet. You will attract everything. You will attract even the bad things. You will attract even the good things. Because it is needed. That name is needed. And that name is not wanted. Because it opened the eyes. You read the book of Acts, you find that whenever the apostles are going and start to preach, the demons are exposed. The evil forces are exposed. Everything that was hidden, it comes to light. Things that were not right, they now be exposed that you can see them. Even false teachers are exposed at this name. When you preach Jesus seriously, false teachers won't have peace. They won't have peace. There is peace in the name of Jesus. Have I passed time? Way too much. Let me give this. Can you? Let me give this other two. So you never understand. Not only peace, there is power in the name of Jesus. You have been given power. Look at what John 1, verse 12 said. To those who believe,
yes.
God has done what?
Yes.
Has given
power.
To do what?
To be?
Let me ask you, if you are a child of God now, today, God has given you power, the power of the Holy Spirit. The minute you believe, the same power that came to Peter, came to the apostle, it comes to you. And that power exposes sin. That power exposes righteousness. That power exposes judgment. That power exposes evil and everything. You. Irrespective of your position in the society, irrespective where you stay, you have been given power because of the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. The power to heal the lame man in chapter 3. That power was exercised. That power was seen. That power was displayed. It was not a theory power, but it was exactly the power. It was not a forged power. It was a power present to a person that everyone knows. A person that everyone sees. A person that the I can relate that this beggar, we know he was a beggar, and that power was seen in the man exercising his God-given right, and he rise up and he wanted to be associated. We no longer with the beautiful gate where he was staying. He wanted to be associated with Peter and John. He was leaning on them, testifying them, and it blew the mind of people. Mhlambe bazikhona ezinye izangoma ngazo zazikhona ezazama zahluleka. Mhlambe bamenzeka nemisebenzi yokuthi bathi njengoba axhwalile ukuba bakho azange ahlawule, bazame ukuthi bamthole ahlawule, azange bahluleke. Ziningi into esiyikhulumayo abantu babakhriphule, ziningi into esiyikhulumayo abantu babangasebenzi, ziningi into esiyizamayo. Ziningi izinto esizenzayo. Mhlawumbe wayengenamama ngenababa, bathi babakhe akekho, ufuna yena yiwo unje, hambe ubika kwabakini, and bahluleka. For 40 years, an old man, 40 wasted life. Kripula ngenzi nekhlahlane 18, bamuphi imali angazokhuliswa ubani. Sengamdala manje singayizenzela. Yile abantu baphushwa ngamawilitiye basiye lapho, babuye balana, baphushwa, badinga ukudiphenda kumuntu. But the gospel and the power that is found in the name of Jesus, it gives you more freedom to be self and to be alone with God and trust Him. He, the power is in the name of Jesus and it healed. Not in that. Again, 5 minutes in prayer. Not in that. In the name of Jesus, there is persecution. There is persecution. It will come. You will be persecuted for the name of Jesus. Not everyone loves the name of Jesus. Not everyone needs the name of Jesus. Satan doesn't love that name. Even forces doesn't love that name. That is why when things are tough, when things are heavy, when we are confused, don't know what we do, we remember as Christians that we have been given a name that is above every other name. If sin is a name, if Satan is a name, if evil is a name, there is a name that is above every name. And in the name of Jesus, every knee and every tongue will confess and bow that Jesus is Lord. That is why when things are tough and everything, there is a name. When you are persecuted, stand strong and say, Jesus, 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 I have a victory. Amen. There is a power in the name when you are persecuted. The believers here in Acts, the persecution is started by that. And that is the reason they were giving one thing. You must not, you can speak, but don't speak about that name. And when we are not speaking about that name, we are not talking about the gospel. We are not solving the issues of life, of sin. We are not solving the issue of righteousness. We are not solving the issue of forgiveness. We are not solving the issue of reconciliation. Whenever you don't speak about Jesus, whatever you motivate people, they will come back and be in the same condition. They will try and fail and try and fail and end up giving up, sitting at the beautiful gate for 40 years, asking only money, asking only money. We need to be liberated from that. But in that persecution, there is a name that will defend you. There is a name that will publicly declare by everyone.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Look at this boldness in the action. When Stephen was accused, he stand bold alone. Not Namatikon, not Nomfundis. Stephen stand alone and say, you stiff-necked people, you have killed the righteous one. And when they stoned him, before they stoned him, he looked up, light and malachalikon. He said, I saw heaven open. I saw Jesus standing at the right hand of the Father. He was stoned for that. That name will bring you persecution. When I was going to lose, I was going to there is a problem. The minute you are born again, you have offended them religiously. You have offended them in the darkness of their life, in the dark place of death. You are now becoming a problem. Why do you change your life? Why you get the answers? You are becoming a problem. There is persecution attached to the name. People hate Jesus. They hate it. They hate him. Don't think everyone loves Jesus. They don't want to hear anything about Jesus. You can be friends with anyone,
But the minute you speak about Jesus, that's where the problem. That's why when the Baba Tanda was alone, but in Zenza no one, Senzi was Zenzi, but in Ninja Ninja, as Zenzara, Senzi when Ekra Zilemban. There is persecution coming to you. Whether you're a pastor, whether you're a layman, as long as you have believed in Jesus and Jesus is working in your life, persecution will come to you. All those who want to live righteously, they will face persecution. Lies will be up. And that is why all of us who are Christian, we need to test every story. We need to test every lie. Lies against the pastor, maybe who's powerful, who's preaching. And they know that the only thing that we can do, we need to stop him to shut up. It's the same scenario even today. Whenever the pastor is not, is doing something, people are flocking, he's opening the eyes of men to see that they are sinners, they need a savior, and changing their life, no one will like that. Even the peach of the hair from Devon, they won't like that. That persecution will come. But be strong. The Lord has overcome. He's with you. Lastly, in the name of Jesus, there is providence. The providence is grace showed in patient. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God was patient with us. Also, you need to be patient with those who are still in darkness by slowly throwing words of Jesus Christ. God's patience is about us. God is love. He cares. God is available to you at any time. And His grace is a means of calling you to Him in difficult situations. But the Lord, there is hope. God has provided that hope. Let me say this. I know things are hard. There's corona, there's unemployment, there's difficulty. We all face that. Financial difficulties. Even in that difficulties, there is God. Please remember this. God is available at any time. Agasi vaccine atulagad. You don't need vaccine, you need God. Yes, your body might need that. You need to be careful, but you need God. He's always available. And you can avail yourself to God even if you are not in this building. There is providence. God can provide you with food. God can provide you in your need. God will take care of your need. Sometimes you need to be on your need. Make this salvation work. So that no one can deceive you. So that you won't stay away. Make it work. God is there for you. He cannot lie. He provides salvation. If you are in Christ, you are a new creation. And He will provide for everything you need. Not what you want. The needs are provided. Food, shelter, clothes. God provides for you. Be close to Him. Remind yourself to use this name of Jesus effectively. It eliminates every false news. It eliminates every evil. The name of Jesus is what we are given. Thank you for your patience. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you. God help us. We know that, Lord, sometimes we are weak. Lord, cause our eyes to see good in other people. Cause our eyes to see the opportunity to present your Son. We know we are not answers to anyone. We know we don't have what can help people. But what you have given us, in the name of Jesus, help us not to stop. Yes, help us to stop sinning. But help us not to stop to speak about the name. You have said if we don't speak, even amaje azokuluma, we need to talk about the grace that you have bestowed to men so that people can see that, Lord, you are still alive. There's great opportunity in the world. There's great opportunity in every circumstances that Jesus might be known. Oh Lord, help us to use the name of Jesus. For there is peace in the name of Jesus. For there is power in the name of Jesus. For there is persecution in the name of Jesus. But there is providence, great providence. He said, I will never leave you alone. I shall be with you till the end of the earth. And if I go to the home and prepare a place where, so that where I am, you shall be there also. You said to us, Lord, let us believe. Let us believe that you are God. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we thank you for grace. We thank you for the people of my Lord. We thank you even for the time that have given us to speak to them. Lord, help us to take the name of Jesus seriously, to take the name of Jesus in our circumstances, to be closer to you in prayer, in reading of the word, so that our salvation, our Christianity might be known even by people who are not Christian. They must point and say, these are Christian. We thank you and we praise you. Let those, Lord, who are discouraged, let those, Lord, who need help, help them. Let those, Lord, who are unemployed, you know the world and the fullness belong to you. You take care of your own people. Let those who are losing hope, who are under persecution, who don't know what they can do, there is refuge in the house of the Lord. Let those, Lord, who are hurt by circumstances of life, who don't have any means to survive, oh Lord, Jehovah Jireh, who have provided salvation, you can still provide food, money, and everything in their need. You are God, oh God of grace and God of honor, in the disappearance of hope that is not found in many homes, in a discouragement of heart, failing of heart. We pray that, Lord, help these people who are here, even those who are listening, that, Lord, are discouraged because Corona has taken their work, Corona has taken their hope, they have no other means. Open their eyes like Hagar in the wilderness. That, Lord, in the desert, you opened the water and let the child drink. Oh, Lord, you are there. You are always with us. You are always ministering to us. Help our eyes to see. Let us see your son. And let all the hope be revived in our heart. That as we stand, as we walk, the Lord is our shepherd. He is our provider. We shall not want. And he will always help us. Heavenly Father, thank you. Grace us and help us. Oh Lord, help our children. Yes. Let them be strong like Daniel and everything. Let them be example. And those who are named under the name of Jesus, let them not take your name in vain. Help the mothers, the fathers, the sisters, even in the condition that they are in, the condition that is helpless. But let them rejoice in their heart that they know you, O God. Let them rejoice in their heart that you know them, that they are children of God. Lord, grace, we need you, and we need you every day. Grant that the special grace, grant that unity, grant that peace of mind. Help us to reason better through your power. And we thank you. Amen.
What a powerful name it is.